There's a new film in a long-running series opening soon that symbolizes everything that's wrong with modern movie making. A film aimed at a loyal audience so devoid of taste and sycophantic in devotion as to render it essentially critic-proof, and whose star is a horrifying inhuman creature realized through extensive makeup effects. That movie
isn't out yet, so let's talk about Halloween 2. John Carpenter's Halloween is one of those number zero movies that's been copied so many times and set so many trends in motion that it probably never needed to be remade. And yet, a remake is exactly what we got in 2007, courtesy Rob Zombie. And for a minute there, it actually almost worked. The first half, at least, was pretty damn excellent, starting off with a radical but sensibly realized new backstory for Michael Myers, and continuing into some pretty fascinating new territory, focusing on the relationship between Michael and Dr. Loomis. Good stuff, right track, and then it goes and falls apart in the second half with an abbreviated reenactment of the original film, most of which was apparently imposed on Zombie by the producers, making this possibly the first recorded case of a horror remake sucking because it tried to keep too much from the original film. Now, in the sequel, Zombie appears to have been freed from most of the franchise constraints that held him back the last time. The result is a film that still doesn't quite gel, but is at least a boldly original and vastly less compromised vision that's entirely true to its own aims. Sure, it has fuck all to do with the theme, story, and meaning of the original Halloween, but then so did all the series that came after the first two anyway. Look, if you're looking for a return to classic Halloween or even traditional slasher fare, you won't leave happy. The theme music is all but totally gone, Michael seems to prefer beating his prey to death like a fucking ogre to his familiar knife, and he doesn't even wear his mask a lot of the time. Ultimately, the only way to appreciate the film is to accept that Zombie is using only the barest veil of Halloween iconography as cover to inject the slasher formula with elements of real-world serial killer mythos, showing us what the world looks like through Michael's demonic eyes, while using Malcolm McDowell's thick-headed, magnificent bastard of a Dr. Loomis as a sacrificial lamb on which to hang the media's obsession with serial killers. As far as I'm concerned, the jury is still out as to whether or not the former White Zombie frontman has a truly great horror film in him, but he always makes a fascinating one. House of a Thousand Corpses, Devil's Rejects, and Halloween don't really work all the way through, but they're packed with brilliant flourishes and moments of startling creativity. They just never precisely come together. Most of this is an issue of tone. Simply put, it's hard to tell when Zombie is serious and when he's fucking with us, a theme that's been working for a long time now. After all, while he was hardly the first metal artist to incorporate horror iconography into the act, Zombie took it off in a whole different direction, eschewing the trendy goth look of the time for a unique aesthetic grounded in schlocky movies, carnival spookhouse gags, and kitschy Americana. Just for example, keep in mind, that song Dragula, yeah, that's actually about the Munster's car. Yet, what worked for metal doesn't really always work for movie making. It's often difficult to discern whether Zombie wanted us to regard various scenes with disgust, fear, or laughter. That's true again here in Halloween 2, as the story careens back and forth from deadly serious serial killing, a darkly satiric B-story involving Dr. Loomis, and the surreal visions within Michael Myers' own psychotic psyche where it's unclear what our perception is supposed to be. So, it's still kind of a mess, but it's a mess with a purpose, and I'm inclined to conclude that it succeeds on its own singular merits. If nothing else, it's much better than the first one, and while this may be damning with faint praise, it's easily the most compelling Halloween movie since Carpenter's original. Given the choice, I'll gladly take Zombie's shambling, half-mad, but fascinating revisitation of Halloween over the uninspired, lifeless, worthless, utterly safe Friday the 13th and Texas Chainsaw remakes Michael Bay's cronies at Platinum Dunes keep farting out. Oh, and keep an eye out for what may be the single most unexpected celebrity cameo in a movie this year. You will know it when you see it. See you next time. Wait, one more thing. Mr. Zombie, Rob, yeah, look, don't get me wrong. We're all extremely impressed with your unfathomably hot wife, but enough is enough in every movie. Now it's just starting to look like you're showing off. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, good on you, man.